Hey everyone, how's it going? In this video, we're going to be taking a look and reviewing Apple Remote Desktop. Now this program costs, I believe, $30 in the App Store, and it still gets updated. I know it's a pretty old application, came out a long time ago, but they still update it, and it works really well. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. So I have it right here. We'll just go and open it up. They changed the icon a bit in the newest update. So pretty simple layout here. So on the left side, we have all of the different ways that we can discover our computers or save our computers that we have on our network. So right here, we have all computers for me. Of course, this only works with Mac. You can get it to work with Windows, but I think it's a little tricky. Anyways, here are my two Macs. Of course, this is the one that I'm using, but this is the one that we'll be connecting to in just a second. So on the scanner, it'll go ahead and scan your network. All of the different devices will come up. It won't name them probably, unless it's some kind of Apple device. It might come up with a name, but typically if it's a Mac, it'll come up with a name, and that's just about it. You can have it scan different types of network connections, like Bonjour, local network. You can specify a network range or a network address, things like that. So yeah, there's that. Nothing too special right there. Task server, if you have one of those, you can connect to that. I don't have one, so we'll move on. Active tasks, you can set tasks or schedule some kind of task for Apple Remote Desktop to execute on a different machine. Pretty cool. And then history of those tasks, we'll get to those in just a minute. So if you want to go to all computers, we have different options for controlling the computer so we can observe it, which is basically just looking at the screen. Oh, I'm going to choose my iMac, observe. So moving the cursor around is not going to do anything. They won't know that you're observing at all. Close that. Control, well, you can control it. I'm going to open that up. Pretty simple. So close that. And then curtain, basically you can lock the screen on the computer, and then you can use the computer like in the background, so they won't know that or like what you're doing. They'll just see a lock on their screen with a message if you want. So copy, basically just copying files between computers. Install, you can install different packages, like if there's an application that you downloaded on one computer and you want it on the other computer, but you don't want to have to re-download it and everything on that computer, just drag and drop it into the packages, press install, and then it'll remotely install it on that computer, which is pretty cool. I've used it a couple times, and it works really well. Unix, if you know Unix commands, you can do that. Reports, you can generate reports based on a bunch of different things, really, from the storage to the network connections to what devices are connected, things like that. Really detailed reports, it's really nice. And Spotlight search, you can search that computer. All right, so let's go ahead and move up here because we have even more options. So file, we can have a new list, kind of like a playlist, different computers, like if you want like a section for work computers and a section for home computers, you can do that. Same with scanners and smart lists and groups, things like that. Nothing too special from then on. So report, we can do a bunch of different reports, same as when we just clicked reports over here. Just gives you a little option of or a menu bar up there. Manage, we can do a lot of different things from right here. We can copy files, install packages, send Unix commands. We went over that. You can also open applications, open different files. You can empty the trash. You can change the startup disks. You can rename the computers. You can sleep, wake, restart, shut down, power on, log out current user. Of course, power on, and I believe wake is only available if that computer is connected via Ethernet. Upgrade client software, so if the Apple Remote Desktop version is out of date on a particular computer, you can update that. And you can go and change the settings of that computer. We're not going to do that though. It's really nothing too special. So now interact, we can control, observe, curtain, share screen. So basically they can control our screen. And then we can also control theirs. We can send them a message. We can chat with them. Just a standard chat window. Nothing too exciting. We can lock the screen and unlock the screen. So you can lock it with your own password. And then you can unlock it. And then task. You can manage all the tasks that you've ran. All right, so let's go and run a task here. Let's go ahead and we'll do manage, we'll do empty trash. So there's a file in the trash, emptying trash, succeeded on all, the file's gone, and it's now in the history. That's basically it, nothing too special there. So let's go ahead and control the computer, which is really the main point of this program. Oh, selected wrong computer again. All right, so here it is. Yes, I have the same background and everything on this computer. It's basically the same computer. Really smooth, probably one of the smoothest remote desktop programs I've ever used, to be honest. You can easily watch videos on here, listen to music, things like that. If I were to guess, the frame rate, probably 20 frames per second. Maybe, on a good connection. Of course, all the different keyboard shortcuts work, so if we go ahead and open up a Finder window, we can do Command-W to close that window. Everything works. Hold down the Option key, turn on and off Do Not Disturb, things like that. It all works. Now let's say we go ahead and go into the Finder, and you want to choose a desktop file. That's what I wanted to say here. And we can go and drag and drop it, and we can drag and drop it right onto our own desktop. And there it is. So we'll go ahead and close this. Go and close that. And there's the file. File transfer rates, of course, just depending on your network speed. So we'll go back to control. Connects really quickly, runs really smoothly. There's really no complaints that I have with this program. It's really smooth, really nice to use, and it works really easily with all Macs. I mean, you don't have to install any kind of software on it. You don't have to configure any IP addresses. It'll scan for the computer. You can go ahead and drag and drop it into all computers. And then you're pretty much done. You can go and connect to it, log in with that username and password, and that's basically it. So let's go and take a look at kind of the settings or the info that we can check out here. So right-clicking, getting info, we can look at the attributes, basically just the networks, all that stuff. Reporting, if we have automatic reporting on, we can go ahead and do that, which will generate a report whenever you want. So administrators, basically who can control this computer with all the administrator powers. And then control and observe settings, but basically just connection settings, nothing too special. We can go ahead and edit these if we want. But that's basically it. Really cool. I wish I had another computer to show you, but if we had multiple computers, we could go and select all of them or just a few. And then we can go ahead and observe them, or just control all of them, kind of like in a grid view. It's really cool. But anyways, that's it for this video. If you have any questions, go leave them in the comment section down below. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.